time for your Copper Heads Up. It's Friday, September 27th, and that Gilmore Girls intro was perfect for a rainy, cozy fall day like today.
So today definitely looks a little different thanks to Hurricane Helene, but we're still here to bring you the sunshine even through all the downpour outside.
And we know you're enjoying a couple extra hours of sleep, but our local weather girl is up scoping out the storm to see what's really happening out there.
So Kendra, what you got?
Well, guys, we can all thank Tropical Storm Helene for giving us a couple extra hours of sleep today as the heart of the storm is making its way through South Carolina right now. Helene Center will be staying to the western part of the state, slamming the mountains, but with our outer bands hitting us with wind gusts up to 30 miles per hour and continuous hammering rain throughout major part of the day. But don't worry, our weekend isn't going to be a total washout because by Saturday, the sunshine will be popping in and out of the clouds and with highs in the upper 70s drying everything off. Sunday, it will be an overcast with clouds and showers at times throughout the day as tropical air hangs around, pushing the highs right back into the 80s. We are still anxiously awaiting those fall temperatures, which haven't made it to us just yet. Enjoy your e-learning day, Copperheads, and tune in for socials to get live updates from me about Hurricane Helene. For CRN TV, I'm Kendra Murray.
Thanks, Kendra, and stay tuned to our social media because Kendra will be bringing us storm updates throughout the day.
The rain is supposed to die down later this afternoon, which is a good thing because we have a super busy weekend in sports. So let's send it over to our Snakebite boys and see what they got.
Thanks, girls, and welcome back to the Snake Bite. Though most of you guys are chilling at home on the couch, Casey and I are still ready to serve up your sports mix.
That's right, Pierce. With our Copperhead schedules being changed left and right, we're here to update all of you on what sports played on last night. Though rain was coming down all of yesterday, due to no lightning, our swimmers kept their splashes going in the Fort Mill Fallout meet.
Despite our Copperhead's performance in the pool, they came up short of NAFO and Fort Mill. They look to reset as they head into regionals next week.
Taking things back home, our girls volleyball team hosted the Yellow Jackets looking to complete the season sweep and cap off an undefeated week.
The ladies protected the pit in style. The four-set victory was a battle all night long, but eventually our girls came out victorious against Fort Mill to prove who really rules the town.
Great job, Copperheads. And last night, the rain wasn't the only thing pouring down on Fort Mill, as our guys volleyball team traveled to Bumblebee Land looking to rinse out our rivals.
And they did just that, bringing out the brooms as they beat the Beast 3-0 in a display of dominance on the court.
Now that we're done with our rainy day recap, it's time for the weekly pick'ems.
And since it got a little too cozy in the studio last week, we had to kick Reese and Maddie out of the hallway so that us and our special guests could get the special spotlight on the segment.
Welcome back to the second week of the picks, where we're having special guests Coach Griggs and Miss LaFave joining us at the desk. Casey, Fort Mill travels to Clover. Who you got in this game?
Yeah, Pierce, we faced off on Friday against Fort Mill and we dominated them. Clover's got one of the strongest run games in the region and I think Fort Mill has no chance to stop them at the line of scrimmage, so I've got Clover.
Yeah, Casey, and Clover lost last week, but I think they are out for vengeance. I think they're going to take down the Yellow Jackets. Plus, my daughter goes to Clover High School, so I'm picking the Blue Eagles.
Two good picks right there. I'm going to double down and go with Clover as well. Coming off a tough loss to Rock Hill, one they probably didn't see coming. But they're coming back home, get back on track in region playing this one. I got the Blue Eagles big.
I'm going to agree with everyone else. I mean, we played Fort Mill last week. They kind of hung around in the first half. But towards the end of the game, they really collapsed. And Clover finishes games very well. So I'm also going to go with the Blue Eagles.
Next up, we've got another region rival, Indian Land, heading over to Rock Hill to face the Bearcats. What you got, Pierce?
Well, you know, Indian Land is really good, and though they lost their last game, they played good on the road. They're undefeated on the road, and traveling to Rock Hill, their running back, number four, Horton, is going to eat. Give me the Warriors beating the Bearcats.
Well, as a former Bearcat, I know how tough it is to go into Rock Hill District 3 Stadium and win. They pack it out every Friday night. With that being said, I got to go with the Warriors here. Rock Hill coming off a very emotional win. I think they take a slight step back against the Warriors, and I think Indian Land pulls out a tight one.
I don't know what these guys are talking about because, personally, I don't really care about either one of these teams. All I know is that the Warriors' colors are blue and yellow, and I don't root for any team whose colors are blue and yellow. Go Bearcats.
So I'm going to agree with you for a little bit of a different reason because I've seen Malik Clark dominate the slot all year for the Bearcats, And Indian Land got washed away by Marvin Ridge in the last week's game, while Rock Hill won a tight one against a good Clover team. So I've got the Bearcats.
And now moving into the final, in the biggest game of the night, the Northwestern Trojans come into the Pit and take on the Catawba Ridge Copperheads. Casey, start us off. Who you got tonight?
So a lot of people are taking Northwestern by a lot. We've got a 38-point underdog. And, you know, Finley Polk has been dominating all year. Those Ninja Turtles on the defensive line have been great. But Lewis Price has been dominating our defensive line. And CJ just broke the all-time school record for passing yards in a game. I think our passing game can get behind that secondary and win this game. I've got Catawba Ridge.
Look, if I had to choose between Finley Polk and CJ Couch, it is CJ Couch and the Copperheads all the way. My pick is Catawba Ridge, baby. Woo!
We'll go 3 for 3. Catawba Ridge at home. Home crowd powers them to a win. That defense has been making plays all year, and we keep it up.
Guys, it really hurts my heart to say it, but I got Northwestern losing to the Catawba Ridge Copperheads tonight. I need all you guys to pack the stands and be loud, because the way we'll win this game is pressure in the quarterback's head from the fans and pressure from the defensive line. Give me Catawba Ridge big. We'll see if any of our new guests can match Mr. Mercer's undefeated picks from last week. But in the meantime, the Copperhead weekend is a wild one.
Yeah, Pierce. Starting it off, our guys' volleyball team travels to Dorman to compete in the tournament, as well as our ladies heading to Eastside to play in their own.
And our cheerleaders will be stunting in Rock Hill for another competition, along with our girls' golf team gearing up to go down to Hilton Head to compete in a postseason match.
And finally, our cross-country Copperheads take off in the Cavalier Classic down in Spartanburg. Good luck to all of our runners. That's all for us. For the Snakebite, I'm Casey Fickus.
And I'm Pierce Morgan. The hallway is all yours now, Reese and Maddie, because Casey and I are gonna enjoy our day of school away from school.
Thanks, guys, and good luck to all of our athletes hitting the field, course, mat, and court this weekend. And remember, if our game tonight goes on as scheduled, it's red, white, and blue against Northwestern.
And just a few updates on how our daily schedule meshes with the e-learning day. Today was supposed to be an early release day, which means that classes were only about an hour long. You keep this same general schedule today. Log into Google Classroom and join your Google Meet at the same time as you would regularly be sitting in class, unless your teacher has communicated other arrangements and assignments. Or if there happens to be a power outage, which might make e-learning a little more difficult.
I'm definitely having some COVID shutdown flashbacks.
But that's all we have for you on this wet and windy Friday morning. I'll be right back here bright and early on Monday. For CRN TV, I'm Maddie Kreider.
And I'm Reese Porter. Stay safe, Copperheads.